All right. Well, again, I like to start every episode with a little learning lesson. By the way, good conversation, guys. Good combo.
I appreciate you growing, Joshua.
Thanks, buddy. Mm-hmm. I'm going to try to be better. Because right now, I'm just not good. Just not good. Trying to be better. And
you're a good dad. You're a good husband.
Sure.
That's it.
Sure. Yeah, that's about it. Kids think I'm cool. That goes a long way. Carries a lot of weight. But yeah, I do think there's a lot when you start seeing, it's like, you need to, not hype up, but like, not support either. There's a better word to use, but like, I'm going to explain this at like a third grade level, right? That's about as high as mine goes. So like, I think like kids are noticing everything right around the house. And if it's always just like dudes and stuff playing sports all the time on the TV, they're probably just going to be thinking, well, I guess girls can't play sports. So I need to like be aware of that and show like, hey, let's put some ladies on there kicking ass. Yeah. So we could see, sure. So they can get like, yeah. So they notice that stuff. Cause they pick up all kinds of stuff. They pick up all kinds of stuff.
Do you preach to them that they can do anything they want, anything they set their mind to? That's job, any career?
For sure. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, for sure. Is it true? TBD. TBD. Especially on the oldest. Got to keep my eye on that one. Guys, I'm going to teach you guys a little something. This segment's called...
Origin Adventures. Origin Adventures. Origin Adventures.
Origin.
Let me go ahead and take the loop track off real fast.
That wasn't on purpose?
Nope, not at all, buddy. Not at all. Origin Adventures. This is, again, for those first time listening or watching, where do these things get the name? Where do they get the names? Where do they come from? What's the origin of the title of this thing? This object's weird. Okay. What the hell this name come from, right? Have you guys ever, maybe you guys are wrapping gifts or... you guys tore your homework and you need to put it together. What do you reach for? The old Scotch tape. What the hell, right? Mm. Where the hell did that name come from? Why is it called a Scotch tape? Kind of weird, right?
Interesting, yeah.
Yeah, it's a good one, right? Okay. I'm like, oh, that's good. Yeah, what the hell did that come from? Scotch tape.
I never thought about it.
Well, I mean, why would you?
I just use it when I need it.
Right? Gives a shit, right? Gives a shit about the name. F it. Shortly after the tape was invented, creator Richard Drew was having it tested. Cool. Good job, Richard. A worker who was using it was annoyed that it wouldn't stick. Well, that's kind of a problem right from the get-go, wouldn't it be?
You want your tape to stick. I know that.
I mean, if you're making something that's supposed to be sticky, you want it to fucking stick.
You want it to stick. Yeah.
I mean, amen, sister. And the reason was due to the adhesive only existing on the edges of the tape, not the whole surface. Okay, already, red flag. Richard Drew, boy, I could have told you that right from the ground floor. Let's not put it on the edges. Let's cover the whole effing surface, right? Okay. Although maybe it's like a, maybe then it gets too sticky, right? And you can't undo it. It just sticks together. I didn't even think about that. I'm working it out right now with you guys live on air.
Yeah.
Because if you have the wrong, like, just think if you had a whole strip, right? And if it's all like crazy glue and then you roll it up, well, you're not going to be able to unroll that, right?
It's too crazy.
It is too crazy. So it wasn't on the whole surface. And the worker told Drew to take it back to the Scotch bosses, meaning Scottish people, who he was insulting for being cheap, which was the stereotype at the time. The name stuck and it became a point of pride.
So it's a dig.
Correct. And so that that got me thinking. I was like, is the word Scotch, is that like an insensitive term? Anyways, this article goes on to say like it's a bigoted, it's prejudiced, it's wrongheaded, all this whole thing, right? Saying negative stereotype. It was made in 1920, FYI. But I was like, hey, what about Scotch the drink? Right? Yeah. So I stayed up all night. I stayed up for the last 3 or 4 days going into this. Scotch the drink, right? Let me bring up my little notes on that, right? I'm like, well, God, so if Scotch tape is,
a derogatory term.
Derogatory. God, that's a big word, Sean. Jesus Christ. Derogatory term. Scotch the drink has to be, right? You would think it goes hand in hand, right? No, it's not, by the way, which doesn't make any fucking sense to me. Scotch is just a nickname for whiskey that comes from Scotland. It's called that because it's made there following specific rules to ensure the quality. So when people say Scotch, they just mean whiskey from Scotland. So what is it, internet? What is it? Can we say Scotch?
Yeah, so hold on. So am I allowed to call it Scotch tape?
Don't say the S word.
Okay, I think it says it on the thing, doesn't it?
It's does. Literally what it says on the package. Literally
the whole thing, yeah. So I don't know.
And it means I don't know if you're supposed to... Have you guys ever had a Scotch egg?
Yes.
Huh? Yeah. Scotch egg?
Is that a drink?
Hopscotch?
Oh, ooh, easy, buddy. You want to get this show kicked off air? Jesus. Christ. Oh, take it easy. Wow. We're just throwing around the S word like it's nothing.
I would never have known.
So now you know, next time you reach for Scotch, you should not only when you're drinking it, you should feel a little guilty, but if you're using the tape, you should be feeling really guilty.
How did they solve the edge to full surface problem? We don't need to do this right now. No, we don't.
I mean, I could stay up another couple nights, get to the bottom
because,
of it.
Because it's in a roll, so I can, putting it on the outside.
It's how does I guess you got to make the backside not sticky. The backside of it's not sticky.
Yeah.
We're so dumb.
That's how tape works. That's how tape works. Let's start the show. Oh, God, Sean. Okay, good. Sorry.
No. Oof. Start the show.
Holy fuck. We gotta give me a heart attack. Give me a damn heart attack right now, Sean.
Oh, let's start the show.
Welcome to Duck Soup with Josh Purple, Garrett Kirby, and Shaheen Milchin.
You're delayed.
Damn right, Duck Soup.
Feeling good.
Feeling real good. I always usually start off with a number of episodes, but I feel like that's going to get very tricky to keep track of. So I'm just going to go with the date.
You don't even know what episode it is right now. I don't know.
It's 11-ish. It's 11-ish.
I don't know if it is.
Well, there will forever be a mystery of episode 9.
There's one just lingering out in the universe. It was a good one, too. It was probably the best one.
It was a good one.
So, yeah. It's April 17th.
Yeah, zero views.
The Lord ever say. Yeah, definitely. April 17th, 2023. Oh, boy. Hey, you guys ever go to, when's the last time you guys been to a theme park?
Years and years and years.
The question I'm going to ask, are you guys pretty good about like rides? Are you guys not scared? Will you guys ride anything? Or as you get older, you're like, maybe it's not worth it these days.
The only time I question a ride is those like harnesses that come over and like hold your body weight, right? Like those Superman style rides where you're all your body weight's against the harness the whole time. Cause I just feel like that 16-year-old kid that like used their foot to like get the extra click, right? When they hold it, they're like, that's probably fine. You know, and you're like, are you sure? Where's the engineer that designed this? What are you here for? I'm here 20 hours a week, man. I don't know what to tell you. You know, and then they're just using their foot to get that extra click.
Yeah.
Yeah. Those are the ones that make me a little hesitant. Yeah. It's not really the ride. The ride, I'll get on any ride. It's whatever the harness system is that's gonna make me think. Mm-hmm. I hope my insurance is up and full.
Well, I definitely don't ride any like local fair type shit because I've seen way too many TikToks with those things going south. So I'll never ride any of that sketchy shit. But I'm talking about like, you know, reliable theme park stuff. Your Magic Mountains, your Knott's Berry Farms, your Disney Worlds, some things like that. I'm pretty good. Like I'm always gonna ride. I'm not gonna be too scared. However, I did ride Tower of Terror, aka Guardians of the Galaxy ride. I don't know if I'm getting older or whatever, but the equilibrium doesn't handle it quite the same. It scared the fuck out of me. God dang it.
They did did you get sick?
No, I just got super, super scared. Funny. I'm usually pretty good at not being scared. That first drop, dude, because, okay, have you guys rode the new, like, a Guardians ride? Okay.
No.
So, do you guys remember, you guys rode the Tower of Terror one at Disneyland?
I've ridden that.
It takes you up, right? You go to each floor, yep. Like, okay, there's this scary-ass floor. It gets to the top, and it opens up, and then it drops you down, right? Okay, so you kind of can prepare for it. This new one, holy messiah, dude. You go in, right, and, like, the Bradley Cooper character, Fox dude, Raccoon dude.
Rocket.
Yep, he's like, let's party, right? And so it's like, he starts the music, and this thing goes drop, swing, you're just going up and down this fucking thing over and over again. And it's like, that first drop, the lady next to me, I reached down and I squeezed the shit out of her leg. And I instantly start saying, I'm sorry, like that, because I just locked up. Oh, God. And I felt so bad and so awkward. I kept apologizing to her as we're like, kept getting flight. I'm like, I'm so sorry. And so, but yeah, I'm like, geez, I got off that ride. And I was like, that scared the crap out of me. And I used to be like, well, you know, didn't matter. I'll do anything. It doesn't. But yeah, I just don't know if it's like, that goes in the back of you guys' mind. If there's like any ride, like X2 at Magic Mountain, that one's pretty, that one's pretty extreme. That's a pretty extreme one. So I don't know.
Yeah, I haven't been on one in forever, but I keep thinking I want to. But if you're turning into a real scotch, then I don't know if I'm going to do it because I'm getting old too. I remember they did a Modern Family episode about Phil being like the king of roller coasters. I don't remember much about that show, but yeah, I remember this for some reason. The king of roller coasters, and as his son became of height to go on roller coasters, he wanted to go on them. He talked him into it. The kid was scared. And then when he did, he got off and his equilibrium had changed and he was getting super sick on every one. And he's like, I used to be the best at best at roller coasters. But I've always had that in my mind that now that I'm older, once I go on something, it's going to make
weird,
me
dude.
Nauseous. Yeah. I don't know what that is.
Yeah. I didn't get nauseous. It's just like that, you know, that those butterfly feelings of getting your tummy were just very intense. And I haven't had that in like a very long time. Plus, I've been like, you know, I keep going to Disney with the kiddos, and all we're doing is like Small World and like the teacups and stuff. And so finally, like, we went with another couple, and I'm like, they let us go. Jade and I went over to the Guardians ride. Woo! That woke me up. I wanted to go back on. At the end, though, I was like, this ride's freaking amazing.
Oh, good.
Anywho,
you're a brave little boy.
I am. You know, I can suck it up. Well, I got to keep the reputation with the kids to think I'm, you know, the strongest, most powerful person in the world, right? I can't be crying coming out of a Disneyland ride. What's going to do for my reputation at home? hey, have you guys ever heard of Saudi Arabia? Because Saudi Arabia is this week's...
Duck of the Week.
Oh, boy. That's right. I'm going to have a whole country on
my ass.
A whole country's on my ass. I'm tearing up. You guys are going to regret hopping on this fucking podcast right now because we are fucked. Let me bring up this little video right here.
What are you gonna do right now, dude?
Yeah, we're screwed, guys. Okay, what? It's nice knowing you. Okay, it's nice knowing you. Let me just go ahead.
Some of us more than others.
Yeah, it's just not. This is not gonna go well. It's not gonna be a good experience. But we're gonna go with it anyways. You know, because that's how we do things around here.
How many half Middle Eastern friends do you have?
All of them. They're all there. Can I go full screen here like this? Ooh, that looks nice and clean. Okay, here we go. We got it muted. Let me get this shit out of the way because I'm going to talk over it as, let me see, and push play. So, Saudi Arabia, right? I saw this thing a while back. It's called The Line. Pretty freaking rad, by the way. Pretty freaking rad. It's called The Line. It's a whole city they're going to build on this long straight line, okay? Mm-hmm. It's 105 miles long. Beautiful, beautiful piece of architectural work. Yeah, right. 9 million residents. You can travel up and down the whole thing on this train in like 20 minutes, right? I think it was supposed to be done in 2030. So it's 105 miles long, $1.5 trillion with a T dollar project. Some dinero. Just came out, I think, yesterday, the day before. They're gonna scale it back just a smidge. They wanted the 105 miles, but they're just going to go ahead and drop it back to 1.5 miles, just a solid one. Okay. so that 105 miles just went to 1.5 miles. And it's because, I don't know if you guys heard of NEOM, N-E-O-M. It's like this whole like area of Saudi Arabia. They're trying to turn it into this like futuristic land. And so this line is just part of the project. And the overall project is a $700 trillion project. Yeah, again, with a T. It's a lot of Skriller. And this there's a Korean company of builders who placed a bid on doing the project. And they said, yeah, we're in the money now, right? We just signed up on a $700 trillion job. We are set for life. Come to find out, they've only gotten $1 trillion so far. And so like, guys, you know what? I think we might have to raise a little more, a little GoFundMe action going on here, because we're a little short in the pockets on this $700 trillion project. Whoa. So I was super excited for it. I was like, oh, this is going to be dope, dude. This is going to be such the dopest freaking place. I want to move here. I'm going to move to Saudi Arabia because it's so freaking dope. What was my day ruined after I found out about Scotch and this 105 mile project going down to 1.5?
Why can't you visit the 1.5?
I mean, I guess you could. It's not as impressive at all.
Sounds like they're hiring.
Yeah, the hot dog on a stick in that 1.5 is looking for valuable workers.
Yeah. How do you like doing the business,
doing the juices?
If you're like the project manager, you're like, hey, listen, guys, I may have overestimated just a little bit here. Okay, we need to.
Yeah.
I had a set of we're $699 trillion short on this idea I had. So.
Yeah, where was the money coming from? I have so many questions.
I don't have any of the answers that you have questions to, but I do know that I need to play this outro music a little quicker because we could have really hit the. You guys want to try? You guys want to try to hit the outro?
Well, we're on different. It's always delayed for you, so
that's true. I'm practically hearing the drop right now.
You go at 1.5 seconds. We'll go at 105 seconds.
Oh, like a T, mm-hmm. Like a T.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's starting to come up. Well. I love Saudi Arabia, just letting you guys know. Big fan, huge fan, but you guys are also this week's Duck of the Week.
It's pretty good, bud.
The effort was there.
I shouldn't have said this week's Duck of the Week. I should have just got rid of the this week. Yeah, let me try it again. I'm just kidding. Okay.
Is anybody watching live? Can they tell us what they're seeing, if you're on time or not?
Yeah, I don't know. There's like 56 people watching or something like that.
56?
Yeah, something like that.
Good for you, bud.
What's going over here? Oh, geez, there's a lot over here. Okay.
They're all from Saudi Arabia trying to get your address.
There's a ton. There is a ton.
It's kind of got like a drone hum to it.
Let me go back over here. It was all right. Oh, it's Seema Beaver. Seema Beaver. Here.
What?
She said, Seema Beaver. Seema Beaver. Sup, my homies from the valley. It was I. Seema Beaver.
He missed the drop, right, Beaver? Mrs. Beaver? Miss Beaver?
Marlene Pillay up at, I don't know if, let's see.
Okay.
Hi, zombie. Okay. Yeah, everyone's rocking. Okay. Go back here. Let me play some Quack Attack. A little quick segue. Ah. By the way, just real quick. I mean, as someone who has done marketing in the past, get your shit together, Saudi Arabia. Okay, don't tell me you're going to do this, and then okay, just get your shit together. That's all I got to say. Well, that's the outro. Quack Attack in the hizzy. Well, gentlemen. NFL draft is just right around the corner.
Yeah.
And let's see. I believe it's so a week from tomorrow is day one. Day one draft. First round draft. Detroit. Let me go ahead and add this sucker to the stage. Here we go. We're going to rank. You guys are going to rank. Or are you guys going to tell me the ranking? I'm going to tell you guys. Oh, God. Let me get a drink of water. Fuck a duck.
Change the name of the podcast to Fuck a Duck. That's good.
There you go. Yeah,
no shit.
New stickers.
Okay. Yep. Fuck a Duck. This segment is called Ranking NFL's 10 Biggest Draft Busts Since 1990. Okay. I put 10 through 6 on here because that for the sake of time. And also, yeah. You guys probably wouldn't have got a lot of those.
Yeah.
I have looked at the remaining list because I prep for this.
Thank
Doesn't
you.
Seem like it, but I do. And I know you guys know, I think you guys know all five of them. I think you guys know the rest of the five.
I feel one, very strongly.
Well, yeah, one might be a little tricky, but I'll just give you another hint real fast. The top four are quarterbacks.
Yeah.
Probably not a big surprise. But I guess you guys are gonna both shout out a name. If you guys get two wrong in a row, I'm gonna give you an answer. So that
I think we have to alternate because
we're gonna get all five of these.
Okay. All right. I like the confidence.
Can we would it bother you if we took a second to talk about these just real quick?
Oh no, good. I mean I need to
You want to talk about the five that we think or the six that are up there?
No, the five that are up there.
Or the five that are up there. Okay.
Like having a cornerback at the eighth pick being the 10th worst bust of all time is super weird to me. Like any cornerback being a bust is super weird to me.
Yeah, it is kind of. Yeah, good point. Good point. But I mean, eighth overall pick?
Yeah. That's not that early.
I guess not.
I don't remember where he went. I remember him. I know Justin Blackmon, I thought was going to be the next big thing.
Yep. And I thought he was going to be stud too. I honestly don't know who Steve
Emtman. He was Emtman. He was, I think he got caught for steroids. He was on the cover of Sports Illustrated back in the day. He was like a big deal coming out.
My kind of guy.
Really sucked. And then Heath Shuler was the guy who hit his head.
Oh, yeah.
Head on the wall.
Head in the wall, yep.
Celebration. He's banged his head in the wall and knocked himself out. And then Lawrence Phillips, right. RIP. He wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
Was
I don't think you. Yeah, but it's not about him being that bad. It's just that he was drafted that high. It didn't work out. Mm-hmm. And I would argue too. Hey man, that's like right when the Rams got really good, right? Like
96. Pretty much actually. Yeah.
So it's like
before the. Greatest Show on Turf, before that they started in 99.
Yeah, 99 was the Titans Super Bowl, right? Titans Rams.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like you would have been a sixth overall pick going to that good of a team. You would think you would have been better. So, I can argue it, but I also thought his career wasn't that bad.
Yeah, I have trouble with this list.
Didn't he get suspended a lot though? Wasn't that kind of his deal? Like he was always
I think he might have. I think he might
for
have.
Drugs, not PED was, drugs. Like
it was all like pot and cocaine or whatever.
Yeah, he was an addict. Mm-hmm. Poor guy.
Yeah,
but and that's how he died, I think. Yeah. Anyway, okay,
okay,
let's play the game. How fun.
Okay, and since Garrett won last week, I think 62-4, he can get to go first. And take a shot. Name one of the five that are remaining five.
I killed him last week, but that's
fine. Yeah, you probably did. Yeah, that's right. You probably did.
Brian Bosworth.
Ooh, not on the list.
Wow. Garrett.
I know. I wasn't really expecting that name, but
I'm disappointed in that. No.
He's like one of the most famous. He's one of the most famous busts.
He is a bust.
Ever. But I don't know who made this list, but I think the point is that he's more productive than his infamy.
I should say this list was brought to you by CBS Sports. CBS Sports.
Okay.
I mean, it's there's on this list somewhere is Ryan Leaf.
Yeah.
I want to know what's up with the Vaseline candle.
What's wrong with my candle, man? I'm trying to
question
the ambiance
here. It's a great question.
It's also great not question. Vaseline.
At any moment, he can stick his fingers in and put it under his nose to feel better.
Actually, a natural soy blend candle, just so you know. Anyway, yeah, Ryan Leaf. He's like one A or one B.
Ryan Leaf is numero dos.
Yeah.
Okay. I got number one.
That tells me who number one is.
I got number one. It's easy.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. Garrett Patrick.
Jamarcus Russell.
Numero uno.
Yeah, we both knew who it was.
That's one of the worst.
Yeah, that's a bad one.
Number three?
Like have some pride. Have some pride in yourself.
Jamarcus Russell was like, I mean, I still don't understand what happened with that guy.
Oh, God. The stories of them giving tape. And,
Oh, that's right. Oh, I forgot about that.
He was like, yeah, and they're like, we gave you a blank tape.
That's right. That's right. I totally forgot about that.
He just didn't give a shit, right? Yeah, he got paid, and that was it. The second that check cleared, he checked out.
He had an absolute cannon, too. absolute cannon.
Yeah.
Remember, I think he was the first guy, like, didn't he throw 70 yards from his knees or something like that? Something crazy like that.
At his pro day or something.
Yeah.
Jameis Winston could do the same thing with one arm tied for the crab leg, so come on.
Okay, we still got 5, 4, and 3.
All right, I'm going to go Tim Couch.
Not on the list.
Really?
You know, I also forgot I have a... Oh, no, I don't want to... No, never mind. Good. You're good.
Wow, no Tim Couch.
Johnny Manziel?
Ooh, I believe Johnny Manziel was 11 or 12. But not the top, okay. Not in the top five.
Okay.
I'm surprised by the quarterback. Wow, Tim Couch. How about Matt Leinart?
Ooh, no. I think he was up on the top. I think he's somewhere in the top 22. But no, he's not in the top five. Yeah.
Oh, I just had one. Rick Meyer?
Oh, great. No. But that's a great pick.
I'm gonna stick with the quarterback thing. What about Akili Smith?
Ooh, there you go. Ding 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 ding. Heck yeah. Nice. Akili Smith, numero 3.
Okay.
Bengals back in 1999, third overall pick.
That dude was surprising because he was such an athlete.
He was a stud.
Complete athlete, not just pocket passer. He could run, he could mm-hmm. do so many things.
Yeah, he was a stud.
Man, it didn't work out.
Yeah, he was a stud.
I got it. I got the next one.
Yep, Garrett.
Rodney Pete.
Ooh. Remember his wife? Wasn't his wife on a talk show too?
Hanging with Mr. Cooper.
Hanging with Mr. Cooper, yeah. Great guess. Not on the list, but yeah, great
guess. He won the Heisman and didn't start.
I know. Wasn't he on the, didn't he get drafted by Motown?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, he's not on the list. Not on the list.
So we have a quarterback and a non-quarterback left.
Yes, we have correct. One more quarterback left.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna go Joey Harrington.
Ooh, another great pick. Man, you guys are just bashing Motown. You guys are just bashing Motown. No, they were, not on the list.
That team, I know. Didn't that team have 4 first round picks that one year?
Yep, and that's a good hint. That's a good hint for who's on the list, by the way. That's a good hint.
But I can't do it. I gotta go David Carr.
Another great pick. Nope, not on the top 10. Not a top 10.
So Josh, I know who it is, the non-quarterback. Okay. It's Charles Rogers.
Boom. Nice pull.
Yeah.
Nice pull, Shaheen. Yep. Ooh, Charles Rogers.
Good. Yeah. Because wasn't...
Yeah, he's a 2003 second overall pick.
Yeah, because wasn't of the 4 picks, the last first rounder was actually the only one.
Well, they went. Anyway. They went Charles Rogers in the first round. They went Mike Williams.
Mike Williams is the next
they went
one.
They went Roy Williams.
And Roy Williams.
Yeah, and they also went Calvin Johnson first round. All those guys.
Kind of the evolution of man there, huh?
A little bit. Yeah.
They got better and better.
they finally hit. Imagine if, like, listen, buddy, I don't care how great Calvin is. We've got 3 receivers. We're over 3. We can't take another one.
Yeah. But like those Mike Williams and Roy. Roy was all right. Roy was all right.
Yeah, he was okay. Yeah, he was okay, but he was like a first round draft pick.
Yeah, but okay. So can we have a quarterback.
There's only one left. Yep.
Can you?
So to recap,
very vague hint. Yeah.
Let's see. A very how vague hint. It was a third overall pick.
What year?
Well, God, I think if I give you that, it's going to really give it away.
I don't think so.
Okay, the third overall pick in 2021.
Oh.
See, you dicks. You goddamn dicks.
Listen, there's not many times I'm loud wrong, but that would be a loud wrong.
Wait, yeah. It's a 2021.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know it like right away, Shane?
I
mean, we can definitely get it, but
yeah, it's got to be
it's a quarterback. It's a third Daniel overall Jones? Pick.
What's his face? No, is it Zach Wilson?
Oh.
But I think it's the same draft class. Isn't it the same draft class? I think it is. I think it's the same. And it's also this. Yeah, it is. It's a Trevor Lawrence draft. Trevor Lawrence went numero uno, I believe.
Yeah.
Yep. Zach Wilson. Zach Wilson.
Daniel Jones?
Nope.
No. Nope. It's.
Come on. The team traded the effing house for this guy.
Oh, trade Lance. Yeah.
There you go. There you go. Yeah.
That's a little early to call him a bust. Come on.
I don't know.
Wouldn't you have Josh Rosen be a bigger bust if he was drafted just as high?
I mean, I feel like they're the same. Is one better than the other?
The other guy
one's still in the league, I guess.
Well, at least Trey Lance was like on the path to starting. Josh Rosen got traded like right out of the gate. Never after played the first a
year too. Yeah.
Yeah. After the first year. That's right.
Jeez.
I guess I'm going to say that's okay. I mean, if you want to put a gun to my dome, sure.
No, I think we say fuck you, CBS. That's what I think we say.
And that was Quack Attack.
Oh.
Good job, guys. Good job. Stellar performance.
Not great. We named a lot of busts, though. We named a lot of busts. Was bussing.
He was bussing big time. It's kind of okay. Oh, geez, almost looped back around.
I can think of so many more busts. Andre Ware.
I bet. Yeah.
Andre Ware's a good one, dude. Yeah.
Anyway.
I think Matt Leinart's a good one too.
I absolutely think Matt Leinart is.
But where did he get picked? I think he slipped in the draft.
He was a first round. I think he was picked 22 or 23 or something like that.
He was like at the end of the draft.
Yeah.
Well, there's so many that have slipped that far that have been.
Yeah, that's true.
That not lived up to first round. But,
I mean, you're not wrong with the Brian Bosworth thing. It just,
And I don't know if you guys remember during draft day, but there was a real up in the air. I've heard stories too about the Colts draft room about like, I think half the room was in on Ryan Leaf and half the room was in on Peyton Manning.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think there's a 30 for 30 on that.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. About like the difference of like, not just the career paths, but their overall lives.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We were kind of talking about that earlier. I think as you're trying to hop on, Sean, but it matters where you go. And I will say Peyton's a dog shit of a human on the field. Dog shit of a human. Props to that guy for overcoming just a horrific rookie season to be turned into one of the greatest of all time. So that's it can be done. It can be done. Yeah.
He had a lot to overcome in life too. You know, that massive forehead. He had a long uphill battle. You know, life gave him an olive branch, you know?
Yeah. And his little brothers, Lucifer. So yeah. last week we debuted a new segment. We found an amazing Reddit thread where anonymous people just come in and share some or ask for some dating advice.
And I
have full confidence in this squad that we have assembled here. We're like the Avengers of dating. And this segment is called
Go ahead.
What? Okay. This segment's called Cupid Doesn't Lie. I mean, it's right in the song.
Give it a try. Cupid, true love. Keep talking.
Okay. And again, guys, this is let's put our thinking hats on. Okay. Let's put our thinking hats on. This is our friend. They're coming to us. We're going to give them advice. We're going to make their life better. Okay. This comes from Deep Coconut 1876. How much longer am I going to suck at sex for? I finally paid for sex at 25. It's a dude. He's 25 years old.
Mm-hmm.
I've had well over 60 rejections in my life. That's not an exaggeration. I've asked out around 8 a year since turning 18. Don't even get me started about Tinder. Many of those rejections were simply for being inexperienced. I finally paid for it for a month, and apparently this isn't long enough to catch up to most people my age. Real quick, I'm gonna pivot here. Many of those rejections were simply for being inexperienced. So, like, how's that first conversation going?
I would like to have sex with you, please.
Yeah,
how many times have you done it?
I'd like to order sex if I could.
Hi, my name's Deep Coconut. I've never been laid. How do you do? I still good.
No, it's just, it's a great question of their bio, right? It's like, yeah, I'm gonna get like, me started on Tinder. Because what was on Tinder? Hi, yeah. I am just, absolutely a virgin.
Well, yeah, he's getting rejected right away for being experienced. Anyways, okay. I still suck hard at sex. When am I actually going to get good? By the way, beautiful spelling of that. Yeah. Get good so I have a chance to date normally. P.S. Oh, and also, women hate guys who pay for it more than they dislike virgins. Learn that the hard way. Edit. I can now get dates even with decent looking women. It's just that my sex skills murder the whole thing. Pretty good. Pretty good. And you got to like, I got to take this guy at face value. Because there's part of me like, this guy's putting a spoof over, but I don't know, maybe he's not. But and even if he's not, I'm sure there's these situations do exist out in the world.
It's oddly how well written it is and then get good.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I mean, correct.
The punctuation, sorry. Anyway, just.
We are treating this like it's real. Let me start. Let's
go, Garrett.
Okay. Thank you for coming to us. You're good friends, mm-hmm. Billy mm-hmm. Ledbetter. There's a reason that no one will have sex with you. It's because you're starting conversations with how many times you've had sex.
Yes.
You got to find a different way to start the conversation. Like, hey, how are you doing? That's mm-hmm. a great way to start a conversation.
True.
And then you don't tell them you want to have sex with them. You try mm-hmm. to get to know them. So what? So, okay, Billy, listen. Sorry, Deep Coconut. Deep Coconut, 1876?
Yeah. Well, if you remember last week we came up with a name for the person, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So yeah, Billy's fine. Billy.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
It's
so
Billy.
When it's it's definitely Billy-ish. It's Billy-ish for sure.
This is a wild Bill for sure.
Yeah.
there's too many questions here. There is.
It's hard. And definitely first things first, give me more info, dude. Give me more info because I'm just going to jump to so many just bad conclusions right now. You got to think I'm again, you're kind of focusing on it too. It's the approach he's taken. I think he's probably overthinking it. He's probably awkward. He's probably like, oh, maybe people only want sex. So I better start talking about sex right away and let them know up front, hey, I don't know how to do it very well. And then that's also kind of like, all right, well, this guy kind of creeping me out. He's already like talking about the sex talk. And we're just getting some cappuccinos right now.
I'm guessing too, that it comes up pretty early in the conversation that he's asking them. How much sex have you had? Like, because then he's saying, well, I haven't had that much sex. Mm-hmm. And apparently that is turning him away.
Maybe. Yeah. He's probably, he's definitely probably thinking about it more than they are it's heavily on his mind. But I also feel like it's interesting there towards the bottom where he said that he,
he froze. He froze like Deep Coconut on a first date. Oh my gosh.
Evan camera.
Okay, I'll be right back.
All right, cool. Aw. This whole thing sucks.
It's my favorite moment. The disembodied voice. It's just so funny. It's hilarious to me.
I think this might do it. I think this might fix it. Let me see. Is it gonna work? Nope. Oh, I just turned it off. Now I gotta turn it back on. Please God don't flicker. I think we're good.
Hey, no flickering.
Yep. Beautiful. Yeah, do you want to weigh in or something?
Well, I also think too at the end, like why are the edit to include decent looking women? Like I have to specify that they're good looking women. I'm not getting basic or whatever. But then to say that my sex skills murder it. Okay, so then you are getting laid. You're just bad at it.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
I think it sounds like, again, this is all we have to go off of, just this little bit of outline here. I think he's just probably talking about it too much. I feel like it's just coming up in discussion too much because, you know, from personal experience, women don't care if you're good at sex. You know, they don't really care.
I'm gonna disagree with that, but I would say, you know, like when you have sex with any woman the first time, like, hey man, kudos to you if you can like hit everything that is hitting it for both of you so mm-hmm. explosively that it's like, oh, this is what it's supposed to be like. a lot of times it gets better with the same person.
For so sure. You develop a chemistry, right? Yeah.
So if you're sitting here thinking like, I got to have a bunch of sex to become the expert at sex, you're never going to be the expert at it because mm-hmm. it's about developing mm-hmm. what do you like, what you don't like, right? Like it's mm-hmm. enjoyable sex is such a two-way street. So Billy, what I would say is you need to focus like talk through it with your partner there. And the good sex is coming. Good sex is coming. I am very much optimistic here for you. But if you think you're going to get good by having lots of sex with multiple mm-hmm. people, mm-hmm. that's not what's going to make you better. What's going to make you better is talking through it with someone. Mm-hmm.
Good advice, like, Sean.
Yeah, man. Like, it's okay to talk about these things, man. It's okay to talk to them. Sure. Like, hey, is this working for you? Is this not mm-hmm. working for you?
I like that too. Mm-hmm. And also,
if you're paying for it, don't tell me that they aren't telling you that you're fucking amazing at it. Yeah. All right. You paid them. They're telling you you're good at it. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Also, I'm all for having the conversation, but also let's have that conversation maybe, you know, like on the second or third date, maybe not right from the get-go, which it sounds like this dude's doing right from the get-go.
I think he's having it. I think he's having the conversation in his own mind because based on the bottom, he's saying he's mm-hmm. getting laid and that the relationship's ending because he's not good at it. I think he's second guessing his own self and then not like, you know, talking it out with his partner.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. Concur. So have the conversation, build the chemistry. Don't be a creep. And that was Cupid Doesn't Lie.
Wait.
Oh, that's just what the song's going to sound like when we're done with the segment. But Garrett,
last, I just want one more thing to say.
Please say it.
Just keep your head up, Billy. 60 rejections isn't that much. I've had 60 rejections in my life. I'm certain mm-hmm. sure Shaheen has. Mm-hmm. I mean, Josh is 3 for 3 in life. So like it's different for him. But like when you're out there, rejection is a part of it. You just get better with everyone. Keep your 100%. Head up.
100%.
Yeah, learn from it. That was good advice, guys. From you two. Right. I don't know how much I contributed, but
I will also say too.
Oh, God damn it.
Yes. Okay. Play the song.
No, no, no. Sean, add to it. We're building this guy's. We're helping Deep Coconut out. Let's help him out. The song can wait.
You need to go down, buddy.
You want to
get really good.
Now we're talking.
You want those ladies to call you back.
Now we're talking.
You need to go south, buddy.
I like what you're saying.
All right. There. Now it's on the internet. Also, I was kidding. Hey, man. Cupid don't lie on that one.
I mean, it's right in the song. It's right in the song. It doesn't lie.
Why is it called that?
Why is it called Cupid Doesn't Lie?
Yeah.
Because we're Cupid. Oh. I think we're Cupid.
I won't lie to you, Billy. I'll never lie to you, Billy.
Right about this time, we cover headlines. Let's switch it up, guys.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I'm going to switch it. Oh, gosh. See? Look at this. Look at this little shit. I don't like that. I don't like that right there. I don't like that at all. Let's go ahead.
Nobody noticed.
Oh,
the
my God.
Shadow?
There we go.
Nobody noticed. He has some bare wall that he doesn't want anybody to see.
It's because it's real wood paneling that I put up. Okay. God. Got to let people know that I'm just like, it's mahogany or something. We're gonna switch it up. we're gonna do a new segment. It's kind of newsy. It's more of like TikTok-y, Instagram-y. It's I don't really have a title yet, but it's something like the lines of like, "Have you seen this video? Holy crap! Did you see that? Whoa! Did you something like that?" Okay, so
Sean, Instagram meets world news. Got it.
Yeah, there you go. So Sean, improv. Can you do me a little jingle, a little intro jingle, whatever your heart says.
Oh, a little jingle. Here comes the news. You probably saw on the internet, but we're going to pretend like you've never seen it before.
Beautiful.
How about that?
Thanks, Sean. I like it.
Great. That was great.
Okay. This is an interview that Will Ferrell did, I believe, on a radio show. Maybe it was a podcast. I believe it was a radio show. But I had no idea that this whole Stevie Wonder is a fucking liar, by the way. This guy's got 20/20 vision, apparently. Bullshit. You guys heard this? All these little rumors and all these skedaddles that's going on with this guy? Have you guys heard the rumor? Stevie Wonder has perfect vision.
Yes, it's been a rumor for a long time.
Perfect vision. Absolutely perfect. So let's, I'm going to play this little guy. Oops. You guys need to see it, preferably. Drop this little
About scene. Stevie Wonder being blind.
I had never gone down that rabbit hole before. Sure. I'd never even questioned. But then the catching of the mics, the Shaq story. There's a lot. The boy George in the headlock.
Wait, what story?
Wait.
Yeah, there. If I'm remembering correctly, he.
This is exciting.
Boy George tells a story of Stevie Wonder once coming up behind him
at a party
and playfully choking him, having no direction, no confirmation, nobody in aid. He just like puts him in. He's like, "You fucking boy George,
kind of chameleon."
Your song from The Quiet Game.
Yeah,
I got you.
Which I watched. Yeah, which I watched.
Whatever. I don't want to spoil it for anyone. Something crazy happened.
Is it The Crying Game or The Quiet Game?
I don't know.
Garrett, do you know the Shaq Stevie Wonder story?
No.
Oh yeah.
Basically, Shaq says that like they were in an elevator, and Stevie Wonder just like.
Well, hang on. I think they live in the same place together. Shaq pushes the elevator, right? What? The elevator opens up. It's just Stevie Wonder in there, and he's going down to like his car or whatever. He's going to the garage or something. So Shaq just kind of walks in, and I think he says he didn't say anything. He doesn't say anything. And Stevie's just like, "What's up, Shaq?"
He says, "What's up, Big Diesel?"
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. And Shaq's like, huh?
How the hell did you know?
What's going on here? What the hell's going on here? So can we just throw the possibility that this is true? And if it is true, wow.
It's a reckless speculation, but okay.
Yeah. I mean, that's how we do. That's what we do here. But is that the greatest? Is that the greatest trick ever? The greatest trick ever pulled on mankind?
The greatest lie the devil ever told was that Stevie Wonder was blind.
It's going to give the devil a run for its money. I'll tell you that right now. It's going to give the devil a run for its money. I mean, so what do you think the backfire or the backlash would be if like all of a sudden, guys, I was just pulling your chain. I can see you all so clear. What do you think would happen to Stevie?
Nothing.
You think
nothing?
Probably not. At this point, nothing. Right? At this
he point, he has arguably the greatest album of all time. It's like he's in the conversation of making
hot take.
I'm saying like widely regarded as the greatest album of all time.
Hot take.
In the conversation, I'm not saying it. Anyway, the point is, I think he's so well respected. Like him not having vision doesn't affect. Mm-hmm. His sales, like people, you know what I mean?
That's true.
Stevie Wonder.
That's true.
People aren't buying to support the special needs part of him.
For sure. And I think he's so universally loved. They'd be like, everybody would be like, Stevie, you little stinker.
You could have told us, Stevie. You could have told us. Did you get one day?
I've always wondered why you had like an 85-inch TV. What the fuck's going on, dude? I don't think you can
believe it.
Not at this point. Yeah, I know, but it's just it is kind of weird though. All these stories kind of weird.
But why would anybody?
I don't know the point of it. I mean, like, yeah, like what's he gaining from doing that? Yeah, I don't know.
He started in the 60s or 70s? He started 70s?
He's been around for a while.
It would have been after Ray Charles was like popular, right? So it was like he was like trying to like mimic or you think
I've seen him in person?
Top 10 album?
It's like he's in the conversation of like the music industry is one of the top 10 albums.
That's a hot take. That's a real hot take.
All right.
I don't know what to tell you.
I'm just saying that's a hot take.
I don't even know what it's called right now off the top of my head, but I've seen him in person. Ooh. And he was guided to his seat.
Okay, sure he was. All these Hollywood people, Sean. All these Hollywood people.
Don't you also like gain super senses when you lose like one of them, right? So maybe that's why he's like, oh, it smells like Shaq.
Oh, maybe. Ooh, there you go. Perhaps. So you're saying if he could see, he would never know how to play the piano?
Do you think Shaq breathes loud? So like he got in the elevator. And he's like, ah, it sounds like Shaq's breath, right? Like, huh? Huh?
There's a chance every room Shaq walks into, he goes, Shaq Diesel.
For sure.
He just announces himself because he's like
Shaq Fu.
You're Shaq welcome. Fu. Yeah, Shaq Fu. Songs in the Key of Life is regarded as one of the best albums of all time. Mm-hmm. Music in circles. Like didn't we do a Rolling Stone?
We did that once. Yeah, we've done that before.
And we had to listen to other people's stuff, and that's why I'm thinking that.
Yes.
Because in the list of them was this album. Let me look that up. Okay, you gotta keep talking.
Don't be Shaq the Fool. go outside and trim my Shaqtus.
Yeah, the only upside I could see is just like he's one of those. Remember Dumb and Dumber number 2 where he played like.
I try like not to.
Yeah,
it's good. It's a bad movie.
I don't know why I brought it up, but remember the beginning of the movie, they pulled a prank on him where he was in a retirement home for like 30 years. Just pulling over on. Yeah. So I'm thinking maybe just he's a jokester. He just wants to be, and that would be funny. I mean, that would be an interesting way to go through life, that everybody's thinking you're blind, but you can actually see. Boy, oh boy, you could probably get away with a lot of stuff, you know, and you probably see a lot of stuff because we're like, yeah, no, what?
Everyone thinks I can't see it. So they're going
to
do it.
Exactly. You're probably going to see something. You're going to have some stories to tell. It's gonna be like, if these walls could talk kind of thing, but it's, you know, Stevie Wonder.
Isn't that like the whole thing? It's like, if your partner was blind, would you stop taking care of yourself, because what does it matter? They can't see you. Yeah,
that's true. Good point.
Are you wearing pants? You know it.
Always. Only the top of the line, too. Uh-huh. Is something else you want to add to the story, Garrett, or you just...
I was looking for the list we looked at. Has the 500 greatest albums of all time, but in the Rolling Stone, and you got to scroll ahead. It's not... You can't just go down to one. You have to go...
Yeah. Websites do that suck ass.
Yeah. I know Garrett's favorite album was in the top, and I forget who had to listen to yours. It was you had a Rumors, right? For Fleetwood Mac.
Yeah. Yeah. That's one of them for me. But I listened to shit. I was excited for mine. Oh, Beach Boys.
Mm. Oh, Pet Shop, right? Pet Shop Sounds or whatever.
Yeah.
I think I'll be honest with you. I actually think right now mine was Song in the Key of Life by Stevie Wonder.
Left me hanging there, you fuck.
I'm like, wait, didn't I just listen? I did, because it was me. I was the one that's like, no, I never listened to the album.
So hot take retracted. It is statistically regarded as one of the best albums of all time.
I'm just beyond impressed that you have, like, you must have a sixth sense, Garrett, because this next video is Beach Boys related.
Whoa.
The fact that you pulled that out, kind of amazing. It's like we almost did some like pre-show like work or something, but we didn't, because that's not how the show is. Yeah, that's not how the show operates.
Don't.
This next video, boy, oh boy, you guys know, you guys know the boner I have for AI, right? Absolutely, just the best. It's
odd.
It's gonna be the death of us, but it's also amazing at the same time. There's a TikTok or an Instagram that's called There I Ruined It. Maybe you guys have heard of it, maybe you guys have seen it, but he takes like he mixes videos, right? He uses AI and stuff. So this is Beach Boys 99 Problems, But a Bitch Ain't One.
If you're having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you got some dough, 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. He's my whole asshole. 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. I got the rat patrol on the cat patrol. Foes that wanna make sure that my cast gets closed.
So good. So good.
94 and my trunk is raw. In my rear view is the motherfucking law.
99 bottles gonna be
jailed out for you, son. Sounds a little Blink 182 as well.
It does, it does. You guys got the gist of it. Pretty, yeah. Pretty amazing stuff right there. There, I ruined it. Pretty epic.
That's the pretty fun epic. Of the internet. That's the fun
for
of
sure.
AI.
Yes.
That is amazing.
That is amazing. Almost makes me want to get TikTok.
The thought I had this, do you guys like the thought of like one day being like, man, I love that song, but I wish this person sang it. Oh, hey, Siri, freaking whip it up for me, right? Boom, shakalaka. Do you guys like the thought of that? Or if it's just like, ooh, you know what? I like that Jay-Z song. It's a little too aggressive for my liking. Can you put a little Beach Boys vibe on it? Boom, thanks, Siri, or whatever the hell AI's doing. Do you guys like the thought of living in a world like that where it's just like,
yeah
there could be a creator, right? But that creator is going to be like... It's almost like a big pharma, right? You got the original and then you got all the generics, but they all do the same shit, right? It's all the same thing. I don't know how that's comparable.
Not
that's the first thing that came to mind.
Not
my point is there's a creator. It's only going to be a creator for so long. And then it's just going to be like a bunch of shit, right? Everybody's going to be ripping it off is my point. So it's like, by the time you hear the song, you're like, I don't even know. Is that the first person who made the song? If we don't stay on the song topic part.
I don't know what to do with AI anymore.
Okay, I'm just saying, do you guys like to think about living in a world where you can have any song by any person in any style? Do you like the thought of that?
I like it when they come up with it and do it, right? Like, there are so many songs that we think are sung by, like, this original, we think this is the original, and then you find out, oh, no, that was actually sung by someone 20 years before that, right? There's a lot of classic rock songs that have a lot of old Motown originals that are then covers, but the classic rock stations play the classic rock versions, not the original. So I think it's better when, I mean, that's fun that they're ruined it. That's very hilarious. And it's very cool. But imagine if it was like, no, the Beach Boys decided to do that fun cover. Mm-hmm. And play it that way and play it live. And it's just so much more creative to me because you had to take the song, convert it musically, which is so technically hard to do, mm-hmm. versus mm-hmm. just having AI just do it for you. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So it's fun. It's cool. But it's nowhere near as satisfying to me as if the actual artist did the cover. Yeah. That's my feeling of it.
Mm-hmm. You never see it the other way, though. You always see like hard ass hip hop going to pop music. You never see like
that's
funny. Friday, everybody
looking into like a rap song
done by Busta Rhymes. You know what I mean? Ooh, like if shit. Josh, can you do this? Josh, can you?
No, I don't have the skills.
Oh, that would be you're right though,
Garrett. Badass, though.
There's actually there's a whole album series where they I forget the name of it off the top of my head, where these like hard rock like metal bands take pop and like rap songs and do full rock covers, right? With all the instruments. And again, very technical for me. That's always like, I get more interested in that because I know the technicality of it, but you're right. Go the other way, right? Why can't we have Tupac do Metallica? Right. I bet you could. I look at Garrett.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, if there was a thought bubble above that brain
there's probably something. Taylor Swift dubbed by Slipknot. That's what I want to see.
Yes. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, look at that. Jeez. That's some now talk about AI. Holy Moses.
Did my candle just start the house on fire?
Oh shit, that was weird. Do another one.
Yeah.
What else do they do?
I think if you put a finger in your
Billy, don't follow that advice.
Oh God, I wish. And the final I'm sorry, how'd the intro song go?
Shaheen, the song you sang?
God damn it.
The intro song. Oh
yeah, I just need to remember it. What's the
world news with videos that you probably have seen before, but we're going to act like we've never seen it. Stevie Wonder fucks.
The third and last video that I'm going to share with you guys is probably the greatest news I've heard in a millennia. Maybe you guys saw it. Maybe you guys didn't. A particular retired football player received a haircut from Vic something. I forgot the guy's name. Damn it. They're just talking about stuff.
You got to have the guy's name, dude.
Victor. Listen, if you Google Vic haircuts, you're going to find the guy.
Do your own research, listeners.
It's Vic. Do your own research. God damn it. Okay, Garrett. Shit. Okay, Vic haircuts. He's got 15 million people on Vic Blitz. Vic Blitz.
Tell you the rules, man.
Okay, you're right. No, you're right. Touche. Vic Blitz. Vic Blitz cut this.
He could be very litigious. You don't know.
Okay, yeah. The guy he cut was just boy. Is he quite the sight to look at? Anyways, they had a conversation.
Hey. One day there's a situation, right? Maybe it's the 49ers, maybe, you know, heading to the playoffs. Offense is great.
Patriots, somebody, Raiders, look, could be, you never know.
God forbid somebody goes down. Would you pick up that phone?
Not God forbids.
I'm not opposed to it. If they would, I don't know if they're going to let me if I become an owner in the NFL team, but I don't know if, I'm always going to be in good shape. I'll always be able to throw the ball. So to come in for a little bit, like MJ coming back. I don't know if they let me, but I wouldn't be opposed to it.
Oh,
Josh. Deep breath. Take a deep breath.
Josh, slow down. Slow down. Don't lick your lips that fast.
Boy.
How fast did you have to go home?
What a sight. I mean, we can all agree, right? If he was the quarterback of the Niners last year, what the outcome would have been? We can all agree on that.
No, I'm not that interested in that. No. Let's say
we can all agree.
Let's say Patrick Mahomes goes down and they call Tom Brady. How do you feel, Josh? This is the real question. That's interesting to me.
I was not prepared for this. Shit.
How do you feel?
I mean, because he can't really be like, oh, if Brady comes in and wins. See, like Mahomes is not good. Anybody could do it because it's not just anybody coming in, right? It's Brady. Okay, here's my ideal situation, right? Somehow the Chiefs are like 0-7, right? And they suck. So then Brady comes in, leads them to the Super Bowl, wins it. That's how I'd like them to. That's how I'd like that scenario to play out.
Different scenario. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Giants are 0-7.
Oh shit, dude!
And they call him come in, on. And he takes them to the Super Bowl, and they win. How do you feel?
Not as good if it was like on a lot of other different teams. Not as good. I mean, it's still badass though. I mean, God, imagine if it was like Giants Patriots Super Bowl and it's Tom Brady.
And he beat the Patriots.
That's like the worst. That would be the worst. Yeah, I don't like any of these scenarios you're pulling out. I don't like any of these. You know, I was thinking like Tua goes on to the Dolphins, takes out the Chiefs at the championship game. I'm just excited the possibilities there. Here's the thing, too. Another thing I was thinking, like, what if, Belichick's out there? What if, like, the team's like 0-7, 0-8, quarterback goes down, they've shit-canned the coach, here comes Belichick and Brady back together again.
To the Patriots?
Oh, that relationship is done.
Yeah.
Oh, you think so?
I do. I do.
Bill Belichick was on the Pat McAfee show today. And just said Tom Brady was the greatest player ever in the NFL.
They still don't have to like each other.
does Brady own a team? Is he a part owner of a team yet?
He's trying to be.
He's trying to be.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I think that was where there was something about where he was talking to a team about potentially being on the roster, but also being a part owner, and there was an issue with that. So.
Yes.
Interesting.
Correct.
I wouldn't. Would you play for the Raiders?
I know. I mean, like, I guess if they're, I mean, you'd think the team has to be decent, right? To even like have him entertain the idea. Cause if you're not gonna be like, hey, let's come. Like when he said the Patriots, I was like, dude, you're not going to the Patriots because Patriots are not gonna be good this year.
Yeah.
Go to the Niners. They're not, their offensive line's not that good to protect him. Purdy got sacked a lot. The weapons were there, but
don't you do it, Sean. Don't you do it, Sean. Just don't you compare the two. Brady gets in front of the ball a lot quicker.
Another white guy, MVP candidate. Hard not to.
I just love to go through the next season knowing it's a possibility that Tommy Tom could be running down on the field again.
But isn't that worse? Wouldn't that tantalize you worse that like they could call him and he could just come back or the whole year? Who's going to call him and then no one calls him and that the whole year you're on the edge?
No.
Or are you in? Or are you into that?
Because I'm already thinking that it's probably not most likely it's not going to happen. Edging. Well, I love edging.
deep coconut, chill out.
You said it.
Yeah, I think I already think he's not going to. So it's just an all win-win. Like I've already said my goodbyes twice. So
yeah.
Well, that was God. What was that segment? God, what was that segment called, Garrett? Do you remember?
It's the news, but you've seen it, but we haven't shown it to you, but we've watched it.
Oh, good for you!
That pretty much concludes this. The show on April 17th. Guys, any takeaways from today's show? Anything you learned? Are you leaving smarter? Are you are you going to use... Okay, you are leaving smarter. Good.
That's always.
Good. Cool. You want to share any of those that you feel like you've started?
I want to apologize to all my Scottish friends.
Dude, right?
Yeah, man. Pour one out for my homies. Sorry.
Oh, sure.
Mm-hmm. Didn't know.
Yeah. We're not good. Any takeaways for you, Garrett Patrick?
Yeah.
Good.
Stevie Wonder loves 3D movies.
And now, your moment of nostalgia.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dreadful, and this is the Dr. Dreadful Food Lab.
Makes lots of gross things, and then you eat them. Dr. Dreadful's monster skin. Care for a tasty tarantula? Fly? Cockroach? You can make swarms! And now magic powder, stir and...
Monster brains!
Fruity!
The Dr. Dreadful Food Lab makes gross things again and again.
It's totally dreadful!
Duck soup!